May I speak to the glory of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. John the Baptist said, "Among you stands one whom you do not know, the one who is coming after me. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandal." If a cross-section of people were asked of the first image that comes to mind, if they were asked to think about God, I suspect there is a fair chance a popular answer would be something about an old man with a white beard. A bit like Father Christmas in that way, I suppose. But sitting on a cloud in heaven, maybe watching what's going on here on earth, maybe not. A God who is detached, distant. For those who have watched Big Brother in the past, or maybe those who have read Orwell's book 1984, such a distant power would be somewhat familiar. Looking on from a distance, maybe speaking out, whether that's the voice coming over the speakers telling you to come to the Big Brother diary room, or the declaration in 1984 of some new propaganda over the speakers and television of every room in every building. Distant, detached, but exerting some form of control or influence from that distance. On the other hand, maybe it might be the image of a God who created things but then lost interest, letting humanity get on with it while the God goes off playing golf, watching trashy TV, or doing anything other than being concerned with what he had created. A God with a response of bothered. So often our minds can move to one or other of these things, either thinking about a distant God who is in control of everything, or a God who couldn't really care less. We see these challenges when we start to struggle with bad things which have happened in the world and ask ourselves, why didn't God do something? Doesn't God care? Or where is God? John the Baptist said, "Among you stands one whom you do not know, the one who is coming after me. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandal." Among you stands the one whom you do not know. Today's Gospel reading is from the first chapter of St. John's Gospel, although it leaves out most of that infamous prologue. In the beginning was the Word was with God, the Word was God. We have to wait until next Sunday's service of lessons and carols, and then midnight Mass to hear that. But we are at the start of St. John's Gospel. It has just been expressed in the prologue that the Word, Jesus, existed from the beginning of creation, which leads us to ask the question, what was before the beginning? And pondering how Jesus existed before he was born. But we move on from those questions to John the Baptist. Too many Johns to consider in one sermon, John the Evangelist and John the Baptist. Too easy to get confused if you're not careful. But John the Baptist, not John the Evangelist, said, "Among you stands one whom you do not know, the one who is coming after me. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandal." Among you stands one whom you do not know. Among you is the Messiah. Among you is God made man. Among you is the Word made flesh. Among you is God himself. Not distant, watching whether interested or disinterested from a cloud. No, among you. That's incredible and amazing if you think about it. God here among us. God here on earth, among people like you and me. Reflecting on that reminded me of the account of the resurrection in St. Luke's Gospel, when the women at the tomb are asked, "Why do you look for the living among the dead?" Or even when the adolescent Jesus was found in the temple, debating the scriptures with the rabbis. "Didn't you know I'd be here in my Father's house?" Here is God, not up in heaven looking on, not locked up in a tomb, not lost, but here. God here on earth. Jesus, God made man, the Word made flesh, the second person of the Trinity, was born to Mary. Born quite literally into the mess of this world. Lived amongst normal people. Got annoyed, angry at injustice and corruption, to the extent of going off on one in the temple and overturning the tables of the money changers. Weeping at the loss of loved ones. Betrayed by a friend. To the point of death. This is God, walking the same earth as us, drinking the same water, meeting the same kinds of people as we meet. This is God, not distant, but here. This is God, understanding what it is to be human. Not by watching a reality TV show about it, not by reading an autobiography. No. This is God, fully human as well as fully God, experiencing all that being human entails here on earth. That is what we are preparing to celebrate at Christmas. And surely this is a reason to rejoice, as the epistle says. Rejoice, pray without ceasing, giving thanks to God, the God who created us, the God who knows each of us by name, the God who loves each and every one of us with the whole of his being, the God who is faithful. The God who was born amongst us 2,000 or so years ago, amongst us. John the Baptist said, "Among you stands one whom you do not know, the one who is coming after me. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandal." In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.